Don't miss our Secrets to Painting Eye Lenses for the Imperial Knight.
Spiking bits.
Welcome back, Hobby Maniacs. I'm Rob Bear, and today we're going to show you how easy it is to paint those eye lenses on all the Night Titans that are going to be hitting the tabletops here soon. Turns out it's secretly easy. And you know what else is secretly easy? Using the same method to paint the eye lenses on like Space Marines or even viewports on tanks. Heck, even the targeters on some of the cannons and weapons on the Knights themselves. You can use this very same method, except for, you know, it's going to be more of a rounded instead of the oval or elliptical eye lens kind of socket. It's very easy. We're going to show you some color theory on the reds. We've already showed you a lot of the stuff in this picture here. We've showed you how to do the reds. We showed you how to do the golds, how to do the silvers, how to do that heat effect on that barrel too. Now we're going to show you what reds to use and how to get some definition in the cracks of those eyes without messing up and having to come in with a little thin brush and just spend hours and hours and hours just making it right. This literally takes less than 15 minutes to do these both eyes. It's that easy. Let's jump right into it. So here's the piece we're going to be filling in the eyes on. This is the Knight head, which actually is, you can tell, way bigger than a normal Space Marine helmet because of its size. It's gonna go over top of this. This is a 3D printed one from Shapeways via Gadgets Plus store there. So it's gonna be a little bit easier to see the delineation between the colors here, but also this will give you a good idea of how you can blend a little bit bigger lenses and viewports and such on your vehicles. When to that end, we're also going to paint this little sight here on the AA guns as well as we go along, so you can see kind of two different uses for this. So the first color, we're still going to be messing around with these scale 75s. First up is deep red. Real quick, deep red, all the scales, you can't really judge from what they look like outside of the bottle because this looks like a purple red. And if I look over in my palette here that I've got out, the Everlasting Water palette here, you can see I've got my colors set up. And you can tell it's not a true purple red right there. So don't always judge all the bottles here. You need to get in here and get your hobby on with a lot of these scale 75s to try to figure out how they work. So once we get some paint on our brush here, the key is your angle of attack. Now, we did something similar with the Ixion Hail model that we painted last spring from Forge World. So it's all about your angle of attack. So we're gonna get in here from this angle and we're gonna pull towards us so we can maintain control. And then we're gonna flip the miniature around and finish off from this angle, pulling down towards us. And that way, hopefully, we don't get any reds on our golds. When you're done with that, it's time for the next color, which is going to be blood red. Not quite the blood red you probably remember from the old G-Dub days, but it is similar. I would say it's more of a red gore from the old G-Dub line. If you're familiar with the late 90s, early 2000s mixtures of paints from Games Workshop. So same deal, we're gonna get some paint on our brush. We're gonna get in here from the same angle, but we're not gonna go all the way back now. And actually, since I'm on my wet palette, I'm gonna make sure we're a little translucent, a little thin down. And after we get a good tip on our brush by twisting it on the wet palette, that we're just gonna go in here and pull about halfway back or so, something like that. And this, of course, is a little bit easier because you only have to go in the one direction. You don't have to cross hatch it back. like we did with our base coat color. So again, same deal. A little watery, a little thin, kind of pull about halfway back or so. So I'll be honest, we're still kind of working with the Scale 75s, learning to use the opaques. We use the metals, they airbrush great, they brush on great. If you've seen our Scale 75 tutorial slash kind of reveal of the line and our thoughts on it, then you kind of know how we feel about all that and saw the metals tutorial that was inside of that unboxing and review as well. These color paints are, you know, way more, I guess, opaque than what I'm used to. So I had to go back and give it a couple extra coats there. I don't know whether it was because we're using the wet palette here, but it definitely makes, or it seems to make it easy for blending. So this is about two more coats of that blood red built up from the front of the eye to the back of the eye, or about halfway. So now we're gonna move on to Antares Red, which is a very bright red, almost like a Ferrari red, or I suppose a blood red out of the old G-Dub line. And once we get a good tip on our brush, we're gonna get in here and apply a little bit more paint, but this time going about halfway over what we've already done with the previous color that was blood red. And you can see here, it is an opaque paint, but it's very translucent. Again, I'm not sure if that's because I have it on a wet palette, but I mean, this is wonderful blending for very little effort is what I'm seeing here. So I am definitely loving these paints, not just the metals, but now the color paints as well. I don't know if these, I think this was part of the original 75 line, and these come in the set of 63 paints that you can purchase, the original scales, and not the fantasy line. So I'm not sure that you can even get these in a small 8-pack. They do have a red set, but I think that's part of the fantasy line. So these colors, you may have to buy separately, that we're doing in this triad right here. But if you're looking to pick these up, there's, you know, lots of retailers. We obviously favor Elric's. You can check out their link in the post below. That's where we got these from. And I'm really digging that. I think we can just jump right into the next color. Next up, I'm gonna mix in a little Mars Orange to the Antares Red to make that color that kind of looks like the same color when you mix ketchup and mustard on your plate, like when you're eating a hot dog or something. That seems to work pretty well. So we're just gonna get right in here in the corner with it, and it's really starting to pop some contrast right there. I love that little eye socket look. Now, I'm not sure if it's going to be a translucent. That's why I'm doing both sides while we're talking, because I want to see how translucent this paint really is. So when I flip back, is it still going to be blended? And it looks like it is. I'm loving this stuff. So I'm going to wait, let it dry fully, and maybe give it another coat. That turned out pretty good. I'm happy with it, and I'm ready to go ahead and just go straight Mars Orange. I wasn't sure how this would react, but I feel like we can just go straight orange in here in the very corner of the eye. So that's what we're gonna do. And it may work, it may not. We're about to find out. And we'll give it some time to dry. But going over here, and just getting in that front. Oh, wow. That really, I feel like that worked. So that is looking fresh. We got a really nice fade through just four easy shades. I guess five, because we mixed the Antares and the Mars together 50-50. So now, we're not going to stop there. We got two more important steps here, and one is a combo step that I'm about to show you. Next up is the application of a glaze using our future floor wax. And the reason I'm not using any of the quick shades or anything from Army Painter is because I like the gloss effect to this. So we're going to grab a little of our first deep red right there. We don't have to have a whole lot for this at all. We're going to add a couple of drops of future floor wax. That was probably way too much. This does not react the same. Oh, I guess it does. With, I would say 50-50 future floor wax and water. Okay, so there you can see the glaze we made. Let me grab another cap here so you can see exactly how, well, mostly exactly how this is gonna look. So it is a thin glaze. We're gonna add another drop. Don't really want it that thin. Sometimes making glazes is a little difficult because you don't get the parts quite right. So let's see. This is more of the opaqueness I'm looking for right here, like something like up here. Let's find a cap that hasn't been used. This is more what we're going for. Something like this. So more of a filter than anything. Maybe one shade lighter. There we go. Just to bring those four colors together in the eye socket. But what this is also gonna do is, because it is future floor wax and it is gonna have a glaze to it, right? It's basically a gloss. So when we put this in here, this is going to give us a gloss for the next step that you're about to see. So that kind of brought it all together. It is going to be shiny. We'll flip around and go right here. And we'll put that under the fan and let that dry up real quick. So once it's dry, you can see that it really faded down those five shades into each other and created a great filter, but also a little bit of gloss in there to give our next step a little bit more viscosity to kind of flow through. So what we're gonna do is grab another palette and some Citadel Nuln Oil gloss. The gloss in here is gonna help it flow. The future floor wax on the eyeball is gonna help it flow. And we're gonna dilute this just a little bit. And you could use mediums or whatever you want here. There's no right answer. Not sure that's kind of the color we're going for. Yeah, I guess it is. Might wanna be a little bit darker. Nah, that'll work. Sometimes you just gotta try it just to see. So what this is gonna do is it's actually gonna get into the cracks and give us the contrast over everything. Whereas with the red, it just kind of pulled it all down together. So we'll grab our piece again, get it in focus for you, and go in here and make sure that we get into the cracks around the eye. So there's with the Nuln Oil and without the Nuln Oil. So a lot more definition over here on the right with Nuln Oil and without on the left. Definitely a night and day difference. Just slightly watered down. I mean, you could go straight Nuln Oil gloss out of the pot if you really wanted to, but over this area, it may coffee stain a little bit, but it might not have either because we did put the future floor wax in there. So that is pretty much our completed eye. We could put a little dot of white in the back right corners or the back corners of each of the eye sockets right there. I'm not going to, but I did on this viewport right here, or this targeter, and then I'll actually give it a little bit of this non oil here around this just to form a definition with the metal that is probably lacking. Yeah, now you can see. So that worked out very well. So that is it. So very, very quick and easy guide to painting red eye sockets, lenses, portals, targeters, whatever you want. Pretty much the same way here. They're either flat, so you pick a direction to go from left to right, up or down, or if it's an eye, a viewport right there from the front to the back. You can add a little bit of white in the darker areas there if you want. I don't think it did or didn't take anything away from this particular tutorial by us not. But again, that is up to you. So real quick, the colors we used in ascending order, I suppose, are some of the new Scout 75s that I think work great and easily blended well together. And then a little Nuln Oil gloss with a glaze of deep red before the gloss. Now there's a bunch of little particulars in there, so make sure you watch the whole video and don't just skip to the end to see what colors we use, because you might miss a couple of the finer points and mess up there. Now if you like these features, make sure you subscribe to the channel and mash that notifications button so you can be the very first to like and comment on all of our video features here.
Deleted scenes, bonus content, and all the interviews and post-game wrap-up videos can be located in the Hall of Veterans on thelongwar.net. Visit thelongwar.net today and try a week completely free with no strings attached. That's not all. Thelongwar.net is also your hobby resource for exclusive early access with an ad-free experience to all your favorite videos. Members of the Hall of Veterans gain early exclusive access to multiple hobby videos.